arriving at a solution is one thing, communicating that solution to the many stakeholders who are involved is quite another thing. I'll give an example. When we worked in HIV prevention, we arrived at a critical aspect of the solution, which is to say containing violence against the sex worker community was crucial to HIV prevention. It was that violence in the sex transaction that led to unsafe sex. Now, this is all very well. The sex workers bought into it. They were energized by it. They had found ways to combat violence. But we had to take this answer back to the government of India and say, you now must work on making sex workers safe to prevent their facing tremendous violence from being beaten up because they didn't use condoms. And the government was saying, well, hang on. We're not in the business of, you know, making sex workers safe. Sex works might be, you know, even considered illegal. How do you sell that solution? I think you can only sell that solution in this instance by showing data. You can't wave your hands and say, here's a solution, it's a good solution, please use it. You have to start by showing data, and data is always effective if you have a story behind it. I met a sex worker in Coimbatore. She had been badly beaten up yesterday. And the reason why she was beaten up is because she didn't use a condom. I met sex worker after sex workers in Madurai, in Salem. I'm making this up, but these were the kinds of conversations. That is data. And you're telling it in their words. Sometimes it even helps to have the consumer there herself telling the story. You don't have to tell the story on behalf of someone else. Storytelling is essentially important. It's very important for that storytelling to point to some data and evidence. Otherwise, you're just telling a story. You're waving your hands and just telling a story. That itself is not enough.